Hey, guys.
So, Cody, how do you actually look at a fascinator?
Say again?
How do you look in a fascinator?
Fantastic.
It's Cody Simpson who looks fantastic in everything.
That's very true. So what made you want to rep the cup?
I tell you what, I was approached about singing the anthem at the Melbourne Cup Carnival, and it's actually the first time I've ever had the opportunity to do it. And it just felt like a really timely thing for me, especially having moved home last year. It's kind of a homecoming thing, and I never got to sing it even before I moved to the States. So being back here now and being a proud Aussie resident again, it just felt like a good time and one of the most prestigious events that I could possibly be asked to do it at. So
Cody, we know that wherever you are in the world, singing the national anthem always goes off without a hitch. Let's take a little look at Fergie here for an example.
It's so funny you show that one because I've watched that video more times than you guys would like to know. I remember when I was asked. It was the first thing I put on and showed my friends and my girlfriend and stuff, like her doing that. And I was like, if I can be better than this, I'm good to go.
Have you done your prep, Cody? You've got the words down, Pat. You're going to have a go at the second verse.
I'm good. I don't know the second verse. I know something about this Radiant Southern Cross. Do you guys know it?
Yes.
Do you really?
I do. I love the second verse.
I was
the
never asked to sing that part, yeah. Yeah, I only know the first one, but I may. I don't know what they're going to spring on me last minute, but...
You've got some work to do between now and race day.
Pretty busy these days, but you are still releasing music. Let's say you sing the anthem, you don't chuck a Fergie and people love it. Do you think you'll keep touring?
Yeah, absolutely. I've been talking about this a little bit lately. I released a fair bit of music this year. I released an album earlier this year, but I'm still playing, still writing music every day, and I always say that the day I stop swimming, I'll jump right back into playing music, and that's what I see myself doing for the rest of my life beyond sports. So
you do realise though that if you wear like a sleeveless shirt in all of your music videos, no one can actually hear you singing.
It's one or the other, is it?
Well, I mean, apparently so. I couldn't hear anything, but you seem like a great guy.
I do want to ask. We've got to go to the break, but Paris 2024. How confident are you feeling? I know that's sort of the main game for now.
Yeah, that's the next goal. That's the next goal for me. So I'm back in the full swing with training. I mean, I had an awesome time this year at the Commonwealth Games, and I always said that anything in advance of going for that Paris team would be a bonus, and this year was a bonus. And to be able to represent my country for the first time was awesome. And the Olympics is the end goal, but we'll just see. I'll do everything I can.
And we should say a huge congrats too, because I don't think we've spoken to you since you got that medal. So congrats on that, Cody. And you'll be able to catch Cody Simpson and all the action at the Melbourne Cup live on Channel 10 on Tuesday, November 1. Please thank Cody.
Thanks, guys.